Where are we?
Yikes! Where are we?
I just asked you. Hey, look at all the trees.
Flowers, too.
Oh, all the flowers and birds and sunlight. It's beautiful.
Why, this can't be a lullaby river. It's so different. Look, we can even see our faces in the water. See? Bend over.
Watch out.
Wow, it feels so good. I'm going to swim underwater, and I bet I'll even see a fish. I just, ow. Hey, are you a turtle?
Of course, don't I look like one?
Well, you're kind of,
oh, hello. Can you tell us where we are?
Why, you're on Lullaby River.
Well, we can't be. In Midville, we aren't allowed to swim in Lullaby River, and it's...
Well, city folks, eh?
Well, yes, but Lullaby River is ugly, and this is so beautiful.
Well, country rivers are different.
Is that why you're so weird looking?
She's not weird. She's like all the creatures I've seen in books.
Hi, what's your name?
My name's Mimi. What's yours?
Teddy. I'm glad to meet another turtle. There aren't many animals left in Midland.
Well, except for a lot of bogs.
Bogs?
Yes. Bogs have taken over all of the streets and rivers in Midville. They're horrible. They write on the walls and throw trash in the streets, and they smell awful. We can't play games or go swimming. And all of the birds have flown away. Why, everybody hates them. But no one will do anything, and that's why we've run away. We've got to get help.
I've never seen any bogs. I don't know who could help you.
Gosh, who's calling?
Oh, that's Anna May. She lives by the river. Hey, maybe she can help. Well, I'm sure she'd love to meet you. Well, see you later. So long.
Bye.
Bye. Thank you.
Yoo-hoo, boys.
Gosh, where is she?
The leaves of the tree parted, and there, sitting on a branch, was a lady wearing a big hat. In one hand, she held a donut. In the other, a long, twisting vine. Suddenly, she swung down on the vine, past the boys, and right into her house through the open kitchen window. Then she sailed back out with a plate full of donuts and offered them to her guests.
Hi, my name's Anna May, and if you want to ask me for anything, you should say, Anna May I. Anna May, Anna May not. Hi, Anna May. Anna, may I have a donut?
You certainly may. Anna May give you another one. I make donuts for all of my friends who pass up and down the river.
But I don't believe I met you. Well, I'm Dash McTrash, and he's Duster.
And he's Tiny Turtle.
Have you had breakfast yet? Well, why, you must be hungry. Come on, we'll go pick some blueberries so we can cook up a batch of blueberry pancakes.
Yum, blueberry pancake, my favorite.
Mine too.
I love to shop for blueberries, but where is a supermarket?
A supermarket? Why, there's no supermarket. I grow all of my food in the garden.
You do?
Come on, I'll show you.
You mean all of these things are free?
Well, almost. I only had to buy the seeds. Right now, I have peaches, raspberries, corn, turnips, carrots, beans, all kinds of things.
I've never seen a garden or things growing. Gee, it seems like magic.
In a way, it is. Now, don't eat all the blueberries, or we won't have any left for the pancakes.
Ow!
What's wrong, Duster?
A little buzzy thing bit my nose. I was just smelling this flower and...
A bee sting. Oh, Duster, your nose is all red.
Duster, put some mud on your nose and come into the house.
Can I still make pancakes?
We can all make pancakes.
I heard of bees. But I don't understand what he was doing in that flower.
Well, he was taking nectar to make honey, and he was also helping the plant live. Duster, would you like to stir the batter?
Helping it live? What does a plant need to live?
Oh, it needs all kinds of things. It's like the ingredients of a recipe. For pancakes, you need eggs, flour, milk. For plants, you need sunshine, air, water, and soil. Now let's pretend this pancake is the sun. Then here's the soil.
What a funny pancake.
This blueberry is a seed. And with clean water and clean air, the plant grows and grows. That's a good recipe. But you said clean water and clean air. Does it have to be clean? Yes, if you want a healthy plant. Clean air, hmm? We don't have clean air or clean water in Midville. And we don't have many plants. Is that why?
Yeah, and we don't have much sunlight, and all the earth is covered with streets and sidewalks. Well, we don't have any ingredients for plants.
We just have bogs. They smother everything like syrup.
Oh, Anna May, it's awful. Bogs have moved into Midville. They smell and...
They ride on walls and throw trash in the streets.
Yeah, and we can't play games or go swimming. And nobody seems to care.
Well, we do. We've come to get help. Can you help us? I would if I knew how. I do know someone who might be able to help. I have a brother, Uncle Don, who lives in Care-a-Lot. And I could take you there to meet him. Gee, that would be great. Listen. Yes, how wonderful. It's raining.
It rained.
Oh, but Duster, rain is wonderful. It smells so good and it feels cool. But most of all, it's fun to walk in.
You like the rain?
Sure, I like all kinds of weather. Here, put on these boots and coats and hats and we'll go down to the river. I have some friends who love to sit in the rain and sing. Come on, let's go join the Bullfrog Band. Howdy, boys. Great weather we're having.
When it starts to rain, there's nothing better to do than to get the boys together and sing a song or two. With everybody joining in, there's nothing quite as fun as a leaping, hopping, beeping, bopping bullfrog band.
Those are fireflies. They produce their own light. They flicker on and off looking for each other. Are they like electricity? Why, yes. See how they light up the opening of the cave? Hello, little fireflies. Will you light my way again? I've heard that this cave was a hideout for pirates. I often wonder if the light shimmering beneath the rocks might be gold and silver coins.
From a buried treasure.
Oh, how beautiful.
I've never seen anything like this before. Everything shimmers and glows.
Yes, in a dark cave like this, plants and worms and fish have to produce their own light. We haven't seen the most beautiful sight of all. Do you see that opening in the ceiling of the cave? Let's go look through it.
Yikes! Those look like jewels!
You're right. Those jewels are stars. We never see stars in Midville. The sky is clogged with bogs and they never let us see them. Would you like to travel up to the stars?
Yes.
Well, let's all get inside Tidy's shell, and we can use my apron for a sail.
A breeze carried them through the opening, up, up, up into the sky. They passed the Big Dipper and flew along the Milky Way until they were soon over Midville. But all they could see were black clouds of smoke enveloping the city.
Why, my parents couldn't see me even if they wanted to. The bogs are so big now they cover the sky. I want my parents to see the stars too.
Hey, look over there. More stars. But they're on the ground.
Oh, that's Carolot, the city where Uncle Don lives. There are no bogs in Carolot. We can sail right over the park. Uncle Don should be giving a concert now. He plays the clarinet in the carousel band. We'll all take a ride on the merry-go-round.
Her apron caught the wind, and they sailed smoothly toward the Jewel City.
Trash and Anna May. So we're going to kind of back up, and Anna May was the character that Dash and his friends met to try to help do something about the bogs. And instead of living in the city, she lives in the country, and you can see right here is a bog on top of Midville, the whole city, and that's why they can't see the stars. And they're headed to Carolot to find her brother, Uncle Don, to see if he can help. There was also a secret bog that you might have noticed when they were talking about the pancakes. And so right here on this screen, there's a secret bog because they talked about the bogs where it would cover everything up and kind of smother everything. And if you look at Duster's pancake, the syrup is kind of like a bog because they were talking about for plants to live that you needed clean air and clean water, and then plants would grow. But of the bogs, everything in Midville in the city, it's not clean. And the country was very different because instead of going to shop for their blueberries for their pancakes, Anna May has a garden out in the country and she can grow everything. So that's something very different. They could go out and just pick the blueberries. And so we'll get this one back to the beginning. And there they are on Lullaby River, and in the country it was very clean. And our next film strip that we'll watch will be the third one, and it is called Dash McTrash and Uncle Don. So we'll see if Uncle Don can help get rid of the bogs.